I think that all the actions that have been taken by all the countries, and then I'm not only talking about the United States and Japan, but we're talking about all other countries that have come out in openly in condemning any kind of aggression, clearly shows the commitment that they have. Any country that sees something that is not within the realm of international law will come into force. And I think that we are seeing that right now in Ukraine, for instance. So we are confident that that all the countries that have come out in supporting us is a commitment by itself. We are expecting to have a large amount of the investments that are supposed to be coming into us, but not only coming from the United States, but perhaps even in working with Japan to be able to increase the activities. And some of that is also being moved from China. A lot of these semiconductor investments have been already started to move out of China and now spreading out into the ASEAN region. And the Philippines, as I said, has been chosen one of the seven countries by the State Department. Well, I think, first of all, we welcome any kind of conversation between President Biden and President Xi. We certainly would like to lessen or de-escalate the tension that is happening in a part of the world. But as far as, again, all of these things that are happening in our region, specifically in the West Philippine Sea, we will continue to do what we are doing, is to supply our soldiers that are there in the Sierra Madre. We will do whatever we can to be able to protect our environment in any way we can also. But at the same time, continue to discuss or to find ways and means to be able to resolve issues peacefully without having to go through this very dangerous operations that are being made by China. We have made that very clear to them on many occasions. I think the United States is also encouraging China to continue to look at the possibility of just simply really allowing us to continue to just to supply our soldiers that are in the Sierra Madre, and to lessen or de-escalate the tension that is being up. I think that there will be no let up in that one, and we're hoping that at some point in time, China will see the light, that this is really something that it's better for us to discuss rather than to heighten the tension in the area.
Ambassador, my last question is, U.S. has been showing its deep concern about the situation of the South China Sea, and the U.S. government clearly noted that U.S.-Philippine mutual treaty will be applied to the area. But is that, I mean, that's, we hear that bubble expressions, but in fact, what kind of more commitment or help by the U.S. side has been given in the area? I just want to understand more what is actually happening in the area in terms of U.S. military or U.S. Coast Guard commitments.
Well, the MDT is an alliance, or it is an agreement. It's a treaty that we have with the United States, and it's been there since 1951. Today, it is even more clearly relevant in our relationship with the United States, and we have said on many occasions, both our countries have made our commitment that the MDT is something that we hope will never have to be invoked. But if in the event that any situation calls for our treaty ally like the United States, we will not hesitate to do so. And that's where we are today. It is still a commitment, but it's really a thin line on how these things can be managed. And that's why a lot of countries are very concerned about this. And we encourage all the other countries to continue to press China, more specifically, to respect the rule of law and the international rule of the seas, as more specifically the arbitration award that was given to the Philippines. That is our stand, and it'll continue to be our stand. I think that it's been clear that any kind of an agreement, which obviously is verbal in nature, is something that that the current administration of President Marcos will have to see. And we've already made it clear, I think, that any kind of an agreement that does not jibe with our policy of making sure that our territory is well protected will obviously be not recognized. I think that that's already been made clear on many occasions.